if you don't have good quality relationships, even though you're doing everything else right, you're not going to have that longevity value that you get when you have deep, enriching personal relationships. And there's a 75 plus year Harvard study that just like blew everybody's mind. When they did all the analysis, they had no idea they were going to find that. They thought they would find cigarettes and obesity and all this kind of stuff and lack of exercise. But the most important factor, the quality of your personal relationship. Those who had good personal relationships live longer. That was the most important factor.
Even ladies getting together to play cards or guys getting together to go play pool or whatever. Love and connection. And truly, right? We're very social creatures and it's absolutely essential.
It is absolutely essential. And to be married or be in a romantic relationship is very, very different than friends. So you can not see your friend for 3 months, 6 months, and then you see them, you say, oh, so great to see you. I'm so happy. Let's get together and talk and see how things are doing. You don't do that with a romantic relationship. It doesn't work. Those other relationships are like the ocean. It's just there and you come out and you can go in and it's fine. Romantic partnerships are like fire. You got to put wood in. You got to have oxygen. You got to constantly keep it going. You can't expect that, we got married and then just be happy and don't bother me anymore.
Yeah.
It doesn't work. My wife and I teach courses, and in here you're going to see some options.
Don't they have a questionnaire, too? We'd like you to fill out.
Oh, yeah.
Did we hand that out?
Yeah.
There should be a questionnaire in there. Just take your time after we're done to fill it out. So and it'll give you an insight to things you need to focus on.
There's a variety of papers in there. You can see about our
class. Yeah, let's go ahead. Yeah.
Barbara and I are going to be doing a class in January 7th, Sunday, 6 to 8 o'clock.
Which is perfect because I'm doing an immersion class January 4th, 5th, and 6th. So his starts the 7th. Raise your hand if you just went through my recent graduating class, right? You too, right? Scott, you're coming in 4th, 5th, 6th, so you might consider coming on the 7th.
Yeah.
And what's the hours of the 7th?
6 p.m. to 8 p.m.
Perfect. Where is it at?
Be here.
Here. This room?
Probably.
Okay.
Unless we can't fit them in. And romantic relationships take skills, different skills than what you have for parents and brothers and sisters. Different skills. We teach those skills. How to talk to each other. How to share without getting into arguments. How to understand why your partner's so different than you. Why do they see the world differently than you do? And you have to have the skills to go through this. And so we do that. It's a very life-changing course for people who are in romantic relationships. We have questionnaires to talk about hormone imbalance. We have questionnaires to talk about your relationships to see what skills you have or don't have. And there's some other handouts in here.
So Elizabeth, you had a question?
My question is kind of specific, but I just started a prescription for Fosamax. Are you familiar with that?
It's
a bisphosphonate.
Yes.
It's for my bone density. And I'm just wondering about the side effects. I've never really taken medication like this.
There are many medicines like Fosamax, and the way it works is that it stops your body from breaking down the old bone. Okay. So you keep making new bone.
Okay.
The problem is that at a certain point, you've got what looks like super bones, but half of it is dead.
Because it's not breaking.
And then the doctor says, oh, you're doing great. And then you step off the curb and you break your leg in a funny place because this half of it is dead bone.
Oh, wow.
So I'm not crazy about it.
Yeah.
The research seems to indicate it may have some value for a year or two.
Because what they said is my next bone density test could show that my bone was getting more dense.
It will get more dense, but a lot of it is dead bone.
It's phony bone.
Oh,
yeah.
So look, take a look.
Yeah, but do you have an answer to that?
Yes, growth hormone, testosterone, all these things are builder of bone.
Right.
Okay.
We used to think it was just estrogen or Fosamax, but that's soft bone. It's not full. You need, and obviously, weight-bearing exercise.
Know that when they prescribe this?
They don't understand hormones, and that's what they're trained.
The insurance company says, here's the study that says the bone density is better, so let's do it. And the drug company said, hey, it works. Look, the bone density is better. And I said, oh, let's do it. So 20 years later, we find out that Advil, Aleve, Motrin causes heart attacks, kidney problems, all kinds of weird problems. It takes them 20 plus years to find out these diabetic medicines that lower your blood sugar. People are dying young, but their diabetes is better. They just die sooner than we expect. Well, gee, that's too bad, but the drug companies made a lot of money in the meantime. So it's a funny thing.
Yeah.
So the research that is done by drug companies, you're getting me started.
Yeah.
I better not say too much because if it goes out on the internet.
There's a reason they're funding their own research, right?
We tell them, show us the studies of longevity and quality of life and what's the, you know, what is the bone density at X point, not just 2 years out. And we know these answers.
It's
not good.
So much money is made by the drug companies. Yeah. They run a huge portion of America.
Yeah. Right. We saw that recently.
Not for the good.
In the whole world.
Right. Not for the good. But I don't talk about it. I don't want people to get me in trouble. The governor will knock on my door.
What we're here for is to have individual consults and not give you generic information, but the questions you're asking are germane.
It's very apropos for me right now because I just started my first pill this week. So
okay, you know.
That's why.
One pill won't hurt you.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And not too much funny bone or whatever.
For a year.
Right, right. You can recover.
For a year or so, it may be okay, but I'm not enthusiastic about it.
Right.
Okay.
So support it in a healthier way, and you can do bone density tests. We have the data about growth hormone, testosterone, peptides, all these things build up bone density. There's a famous example of Ronnie Coleman. He's a weightlifter, and another friend of his, Lee Haney, is older than Ronnie. Lee has been on a very whole foods diet, sufficient amount of protein. Ronnie's been on a massively high protein diet, and protein is acidic and it draws calcium and zinc, and he's got hip fractures, his bones are weak. Even Flex Wheeler had his leg amputated. He said, I'm going to a plant-based diet. I'm not going to keep doing what got me in trouble and cause problems. Now, some of us have differences of opinion about diet. I'm a little outspoken because I've been monitoring with 12 researchers about 2,500 medical journals a month for the last 25 years. So if I see something that's wrong in what I'm saying, I'll be quick to correct it, but I haven't seen that. I see that in those people who do the seven principles, it's like doctor says, we're only as strong as our weakest link. So what we'll do, have you do a questionnaire, if you don't mind, go to sevenpillarscoaching.com/evaluation. Doctor and I review those. It takes you about 20 minutes to fill it out. Then we make sure if you have any lab work you forward to us. And if not, we'll figure out the appropriate tests to do. And we create a personal chart and journey for you. Mm-hmm. And that's the best way to do it. You're not going to get that kind of care at other doctor's offices. They want 5 minutes, right? Quick script, on to the next. Their insurance reimburses that office visit, not what we do.
My doctor sends me to Quest Diagnostics to do labs, right? But it sounds like you have a different way of testing.
No,
Quest is fine.
There's nothing wrong with
if your insurance covers it.
Right, it does.
There's nothing wrong with it. But there may be other tests that they don't do at Quest.
Right.
Like saliva.
Like the saliva and the urine. Or something.
Urine, yeah.
But you can do a lot of great tests at Quest. It's fine.
Okay. I just want to make sure I get all the tests done.
Yeah, but you need to check your arteries. You need to check your bones. You need to check all kinds of physical things that are not just blood tests to know how you're doing. And so, so you will do better if you add these other things we're talking about, the natural hormones and so on, the Fosamax. Not crazy about it, but a year or so on that may be helpful, and you don't stop too much of the body getting rid of the old bone. After a year, you want to get rid of the old bone. You don't want that because it confuses the x-ray into thinking, oh, look how much bone you have, but it's dead. The x-ray doesn't distinguish dead bone from live bone. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Does DHEA have bad side effects? I thought it did.
No, DHEA is a natural hormone. You want to take the right amount. We can measure it on blood or in saliva, and we can tell. And urine, we can tell if you're taking a reasonable amount. Women need much less than men.
Okay.
But they need it.
I use a transdermal cream with DHA. It has pregnenolone. It has some plant androgens, and it has an agent that helps remove harmful estrogens. And I just call it anabolic MD. Women use a little less, men use more. Mm-hmm. And you rub it right behind your neck, and it absorbs right into the bloodstream. And you can measure the levels because DHA, when it's taken transdermally, stays as DHA. Oral, you have to make sure you stay at about 25 milligrams or so. Somewhere not above 50, I guess it is, but that will then be beneficial as well. It just depends on what your levels come up and we look, right?
So is that in your bioidentical? So absolutely. If you're being tested for bioidentical, okay, because I know a lot of the blood tests, they don't test, you know, you have to say exactly what want because they only come up with half the test.
That's right.
And you're like, it's just
a
general test.
We have a panel you can look at and compare what you've had done.
But I'm asking because I've had bioidentical before. I went off them because it didn't really do anything when at that time. But I was thinking about getting them. And then I had another doctor said, no, I don't believe in them. But
they don't believe in because they haven't been trained.
But so what you were saying, it's included in the bioidentical. Like it's what you were talking about, the cream.
That would be
one of the things that you would do.
Right.
The DHEA, the pregnenolone, very helpful for most people, along with estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, along with growth hormone, releasing factors and other peptides. So a lot of things to be done. And they are all great to make you feel youthful. Yeah.
I mean, you can go price check on these different things in my experience because the FDA sent warrants to 497 labs across the country saying you're not meeting standards. If you say there's 100 milligrams, there's not.
Right.
I use a laboratory that's a $750 million laboratory, and they have to do what's called GMP studies before and after 2 years out. You have to make sure if it's 100 milligrams, we make sure it's 105 by the end of 2 years. It's still 100.
Where is that lab?
It's in New Jersey. We have one in Arizona, and all of them are U.S. based.
So you're talking about the labs with the blood or the
creating the products. You asked about bioidentical.
Right.
And then we have prescription companies that follow the correct guidelines, and that's what we work with. We don't mess around with Walmart stuff.
Right.
I mean, you get what you pay for.
Well, there's
really
only
good
certain pharmacies that can do bioidentical,
So the
way it works in the United States right now, compounding pharmacies are the ones who can make their own variations of the hormones and chemicals and medications. But they're under huge pressure because the drug companies don't like them. They want you to buy their drug they make money on. So they're being squeezed really heavily. But there's a lot of, I don't mind using some things that are from the drug companies, but I love the compounding pharmacies because they can tweak things just like I want it.
Right.
And I could make it exactly as to what I want them to be, but you can't do that with the drugs.
Right.
So it's a complexity. The same thing is true for vitamins. In the United States, ginkgo biloba does not work.
Wow.
It's worthless. In Europe, the fifth best-selling prescription medicine is ginkgo biloba. What? How does that work? Do they have different genes?
Because the U.S. people are ordering it? They're getting... No, because ours is...
No, it's because in Europe, it costs five times as much. They have to prove it's really active ingredients. Mm-hmm. Here, anyone could print a label saying it's ginkgo biloba, this much, and so on. Nobody cares whether it's really actively an ingredient in it. Nobody cares.
What about Mexico? Sometimes I go to Mexico and I get stuff over the counter.
Nobody cares. Nobody cares. The over the counter is a different issue. But this is vitamins that are over the counter anywhere.
Uh-huh.
Except in Europe, it's not over the counter. You got to have a prescription.
Wow.
And you got to know how much it is. So here in America, if you're getting ginkgo biloba, you better get it from a company that you have confidence in. Mm-hmm. You want to buy from Dr. Nick. You want to buy from some other companies. You better know the company because nobody cares whether it's really there. If you pay 10% more and you get something that's worthwhile, which is better, getting nothing for 20% off or getting the real thing and paying 20% more. So it's complicated living in America. It's a little bit of the Wild West. And that's why you want someone like Dr. Nick and myself to guide you through it, because it makes a huge difference. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Just switching gears a little, as proponents of stem cell,
yes,
are you familiar with LifeWave?
LifeWave?
San Diego?
No.
It's patches. They have like a multi-level
patches.
Patches.
Very familiar.
Yeah.
I've asked them, I said, hey, show me your studies, and they send me a study, and it's based on the generic growth hormone studies on growth hormone companies that use injectable growth hormone. I said, no, I want to see your before after studies, before and after using the patch. And I say, I've been waiting a long time. I said, I'm willing to do, and I've used the patches, And I have a company that can test the number of stem cells released and the amount of growth hormone released. There's ways to do it, but I don't know why they avoid doing the tests. That's a problem for me. Why won't they do the tests and show me the studies? So there's a lot of supplement companies that will make claims based on legitimate studies, but not of their own product,
right?
Which I have a problem with, because when they're making millions of dollars,
right,
why can't they invest a couple? I had one company approach me, said, oh, this is the greatest. And I said, okay, I'll do a study for you. I know how to measure free radical damage, oxidative stress. Huge company. I won't say the name of it. And I told them the quote. It was like 20 grand, which should have been a $200,000 study. And I said, we can maybe do it with a small group of 10,000. And they didn't have that kind of money to prove their product works. I'm like, I'm not comfortable dealing with a company like that.
Interesting.
So what was concerning to me is it's like a multi-level marketing company.
Yeah, I like it. Show me the
different patches for different symptoms, but
it's the Wild West in America.
What you have to do is if you want to do it yourself, you do your baseline test. Like I have an insurance plan where I get to go through Hogue, and the doctor said, I can't do all those tests. I said, well, who can? She says, well, I can refer you to an endocrinologist. So I went to the endocrinologist in Huntington. I said, I want all these tests.
Right.
And the doctor said, why do you want all those tests? He says, because I do. I'm concerned about aging. He said, okay, but I don't know how to read them. I said, I have doctors who know how to read them, so let's just do it. And they did. I couldn't believe it. It saved me a couple thousand dollars. Usually it's about $1,400. Cancer markers, omega, vitamins, minerals, every hormone known, binding proteins. Doctor understands all this because he reads my lab. And it cost me nothing. I got it done, but I had to know what to tell the doctor. And they agreed with me. And I said, okay. And all I have to do is a fall visit to finish a cortisol test to see my endocrinologist. But he's going to see my levels are all youthful levels. And he says, well, how'd you get youthful levels? You can't have levels at your age. They said, you're the healthiest 68-year-old we've ever met. And my doctor said that. She looked at every indicator, all my lab going back 3 years. And I've been monitoring my blood since 1978. I take it serious about what's going on with my body, not just liver, kidney function, the standard lipids. I got that back from 1978. But my current tests, I do everything imaginable going back 10, 15 years.
Right. Now, you reminded me to make sure that I have to talk about this.
Yeah.
For men and women, for men, after the age of 50, 50% of men have erectile dysfunction.
That's correct.
After the age of 70, 70% have erectile dysfunction.
Yeah.
And for women, they have a lot of sexual dysfunction after they go into menopause. It's all correctable. It's all fixable, either with hormones or the stem cells, exosomes, platelet-rich plasma. It's all correctable. And it's not just that you like having sex, but it's that a sexual romantic relationship is important for your longevity.
Right.
And so that's very important to make that work. If you have a lovely relationship that's romantic and it's not sexually active, it doesn't create that intense passion that you need to have longevity with. So you don't want to think that that's just a cute thing that, you know, it's nice to have sex. No, you want to have a passionate relationship. If you're just having sex because it feels good, you have a new partner every week, that's not an intimate romantic partnership that will create longevity.
So is there studies on that?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It's a lot of studies. So you want to have those quality relationships. You want to consider taking the course that my wife and I teach. Very important. The other area that I want to talk about before I forget is one part of my book is on meditation and spirituality. There are so many studies on longevity that indicate that meditation is a very important factor in longevity. When you're under stress, you change your physiology, you change your hormones, you change your blood pressure, and it's very bad for longevity. And one of the things that I do a lot with my patients is I teach them meditation. And when I teach meditation, it changes their life. It makes them feel calm, peaceful, and then they can be more loving. Very hard to be loving when you're under stress. Mm-hmm. You have a kid, you love your kid, but you're under stress, you start yelling, and then you feel bad that you yelled so much. You didn't have to yell so much. We can learn to be calmer, more relaxed, and in touch with our own spiritual nature, which gives you that feeling of love. Love doesn't come from having a lot of money. You all know what the relationship is between being wealthy and being happy. What is the relationship? There's no relationship.
Reverse correlation in some
ways.
It's nice to be rich and happy, though.
You know, I went to Nepal in 1986. I was shocked. Poorest people I've ever met. Climbed up to Mount Everest, the base of Mount Everest. Poor people. Everyone was poor. Nobody had anything. They were all happy. Blew my mind. I couldn't figure it out. I had no clue how that could be. But when you're wealthy, it doesn't make you happy at all. It does not. Once you have enough money to eat and have a place to sleep, it's irrelevant. Now, it may make you achieve and accomplish more in the world. I love achieving. This fellow loves achieving. And that's what money does for you. It lets you accomplish things because you have the money to do it.
And they say is your wealth is dependent on one of the most important factors, your zip code, where you live. Because when you compare yourself to other wealthy people and you see and hang out with them, you start taking actions that maybe you wouldn't have been so motivated to do.
That may be. That may be absolutely.
But it can also make you less happy because you're comparing yourself.
That's
to people
right.
That have more than you.
Well, don't compare.
It could be. Mm-hmm. It could
inspire.
You want to have a big picture. We're talking about reversal of aging. You've got to have the physiology critical. We've talked a lot about that. You've got to have the quality of relationships. And there's many ways to increase the quality of relationships. But for romantic love, nothing is going to beat our course on my wife and I teach for 30 years. We've been teaching these skills. And then the last part is you've got to have a spiritual life because happiness comes from inside of you. When you're feeling good and your life is working from internal, you can just feel loving. Somebody acts like a lunatic, you feel sorry for them. You don't react because you're feeling happy inside. If you're feeling stressed, they became like a lunatic, you get into a fight. That doesn't help you. Doesn't help you. So that's the big picture. I encourage you to take action steps on your weakest link. So if your weakest link is your bone density, you take action on bone density. If your weakest link is in sexual functioning, you take action on that. If your weakest link is on how you eat, how you exercise, the quality of your sleep, your quality of your spiritual life, you've got to take action in whatever it is that we talked about that you say, you know, I need to do something in that area. So I encourage you to do that.
So the six human needs, if we talk about, just to summarize, if you were to look at the six human needs, it wouldn't be in any particular order other than certainty, knowing what's going to take place in a relationship or in your life or business. And lately, the world's been very uncertain. Mm-hmm. And in a way that's very challenging from a stress perspective, right? But also we need uncertainty and variety, particularly in a relationship. So if you always kiss the same way, you might consider doing a little different. But I'm just saying that uncertainty or just things that go on in the mind and significance, huge, big part for all of us to be appreciated and significant, right? And the human need of connection and love, we've been talking a lot about tonight, and personal growth, contribution, and basically these are the what we call the six human needs. So Doctor and I are here to support you. Every Wednesday, I do a class from 5 to 6:15 p.m. going on 2 years. And members who go through my 2.5-day immersion course, which is regular a $2,000 course, we're letting people in that we know for $198. And that includes up to 5 years to attend these 3 days. The next one coming up is January 5th, 6th, and 7th. The 5th is my actual birthday. I turned 69. And any of you who want to reattend a class, the results are fabulous because we teach you the seven secrets. We actually demonstrate in our kitchen the foods that we eat, how we prepare them. We show you the 12-minute workout. We show you how to balance your hormones. We go into much more depth than we have tonight. But he's my main medical guy here in Newport. This is it. This is where most of you will come. And when you get results like saliva, blood, or urine, we like you to at least make an initial 15-minute or so appointment. And if you want to go deeper in it, there's a charge, you know, for office visit.
So what he's explaining is that for those who are attending the class here, you can make sure that your name is on the sheet here and just write what you're interested in. and we can create a 15-minute appointment on the phone or in person, where I just talk to you, see what your needs are, see if there's something that I could do that would be helpful. And you're welcome to do that. There's no charge for that. Mm-hmm. And you just would call and speak to my office manager, Maureen. And she kind of scheduled it.
Yeah.
And when you do the whole thing with the hormones in your class, are you coming into that? Are you part of that class? Or
he will make appearances. Okay. And it's just usually on the last day as you have all, you know, pulled yourself together. People first come in the first day, their arms are like this, and they're like, oh, I don't know, what are we going to learn? But we go deep. We do timeline therapy, NLP. We do things. We have certain experts that help with that. We work. We have different experts that doctor is the core of all of the hormone peptides, stem cell, the look better, all that. That's critical, right?
And sexual functioning. And,
right.
And I will mention, too, that I do classes on meditation online. You can, I don't know if it'll be in the book there, but I'll give you a card there. And you're welcome to come to those Thursday, 7:30 p.m. class. It's on Zoom, or Sunday at 12:30 on Zoom. So it's a Zoom class, and everybody loves the meditation. I've been teaching it for a long time. It really changes people's lives, so that's another option.
We'll both be in Las Vegas. I depart tomorrow on a plane to the biggest anti-aging conference of the year that I've been attending every year for over 20 years. Doctor will be going out on the following day after Thursday, and I have a booth there. We greet the doctors. They all know us. We meet with them. We keep our technology up to date with what everyone else is doing. We quiz them deeply. We find out, what's your protocol? Show me your results. I mean, literally, not just going to the exhibit halls, but the speakers. And they're all there for us because we're wearing a badge. They know who we are. I get to go backstage with Dr. Bob Goldman, which is a very elite party where the celebrities are invited and so forth. And so this is like a tradition. So, you know, the good thing is we know who knows the most. And there's certain people we choose to work with, and that's why I work with Dr. Michael Grossman, because he does keep himself up on the latest technologies and treatments and interventions. That allows me to go out and really teach people and educate. So my goal this year is to reach tens of thousands of people. I'm on several stages with the release of my book, Stop Aging Now. And my goal is to, I realize people will only get results if they're fully educated. So that's why we have the ongoing Wednesday. It's optional to tune in. A lot of people do, from Japan, from all over the world. It's on Zoom. You get a link. It's $37 a month, but we include it with the $198, the 2.5-day immersion. And if you don't go to the immersion, that's okay. You can just meet with us individual appointments, but our individual time is a little more expensive, right? I can do it in group. We can do it in group like we are here tonight, answer all your questions. We even took you to the side and individually, doctor kind of gave you some tips of things he thinks he can help you with. And we're here to serve you. I mean, that's the key is the more you people get results, you're going to tell other people, you're going to bring people tonight. I see some of you brought some people and friends, and that's nice. And the key is we love what we do. This is a blast. I love seeing people where you're at, so the end stage of life, where you're trying to place them in a care center where they're doing palliative care